Hello students, welcome to the 13th class on economic survey, and in this class I will be dealing with the chapter 13th chapter, that is the other India's two analytical narratives, redistributive and natural resources on state development. First of all, I will be explaining what is this chapter about. This chapter primarily deals with how the development has taken place in Indian states. Now there are two ways by which this chapter has gauged on the development of the states. Now the first is about redistribution resource factor, and the second is natural resource way. Now this chapter analyzes how the Indian states have performed on the issue of development, whether they have developed themselves because they were getting aid from the central government, or they have developed themselves because they were having natural resources. Natural resources means that they have access to the forests, that they have access to the metallic and the non-metallic resources, etc. So this chapter basically analyzes, it weighs both these narratives, which is a better way with which the states of India have developed. Now first of all, we will be learning about the redistribution resource factor. And in this, we will also be learning about how the recommendations of 13th Finance Commission are important. Now, what is this redistribution resource factor? Redistribution resource factor primarily means that the center provides aid to the special category states, and how these states have performed on the issues of GDP, on the issue of tax collection, and also on the issue of trade, etc. Now according to this chapter of economic survey, this aid that is provided by the center to the states, it has not yielded much result. This chapter has delved deep and has analyzed about the 10 states which were getting the bigger share of aid from the center, but they have not been able to use this aid effectively. Now, what is the reason? Whenever a state is dependent on aid, why generally it do not perform well with respect to development? Why a state is not able to develop properly? Now, there is a syndrome, aid dependency syndrome, which this chapter talks about. Now, all the states which were actually poor and they were dependent on aid, they have failed to develop their own potential. They have not worked well to develop themselves. The tax of these states, the tax collection has not increased. Now, when will the tax collection of a state increase? Tax collection of a state will increase only if you are creating products if you are generating something, and if you are generating, if you are producing something, only then you will be getting the people to move the economy. If the economy will be moving, only then there will be tax collection. But when you are totally dependent on aid, then you will not be able to develop. So this narrative, redistributive narrative, is not good for a country like India. So the solution that this year's economic survey has given to this, that the states should not be conferred direct aid. The aid should be conditional, like the conditions that were proposed by the 13th Finance Commission. According to 13th Finance Commission, aid tabhi do jab state perform kar rahi hai. If the state is able to perform, if the state is enhancing its good governance capacity and capability, only then the aid should be given. And the aid to the states can also be given in the form of universal basic income, in the form of UBI. Now UBI has also been proposed by the 9th chapter of the economic survey. So if the states want support, they should perform, because this aid that has been given to the states till now, it has not yielded any substantive results. This is what has been dealt in this year, in this very chapter. Now, another thing that we have, it is analyzing how the states have performed, those states which have the natural resources. Un states ne kis tarah development ki hai jinke paas natural resources hai. Ye to humne un states ki baat kar li, redistributive resource factor. जिनके पास रिसोर्सेज नहीं है और उनको पैसा दिया जा रहा है, जो गरीब हैं, बट वो देश साथ में नहीं आ पाए, दे हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू इंडल्ज इन दिस कन्वर्जेंस थिंग. नाउ एज फार एज द कन्वर्जेंस इज कंसर्न्ड, आई हैव ऑलरेडी डेल्ट विद यू अबाउट कन्वर्जेंस इशू. कन्वर्जेंस इज अबाउट हाउ द पुअर स्टेट्स आर एबल टू मीट द स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ द रिचर स्टेट्स. Now, coming back to the natural resource way. Now, what is in this part, the economic survey has delved about how those states have performed which have access to the natural resources. Jin states ke paas natural resources hain, un states ne kaisa perform kiya hai. To economic survey ye kehta hai ki un states ne achha perform nahi kiya hai jinke paas apne natural resources hote hain. रीजन क्या दिया है? रीजन दिया है डच डिजीज. नो, व्हाट इज दिस डच डिजीज? वी विल बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस कंसेप्ट, इकोनॉमिक कंसेप्ट. नो, दिस इकोनॉमिक्स कंसेप्ट ऑफ डच डिजीज डीडी, इट मींस दैट सपोज यू आर अ रिसोर्स रिच नेशन, यू हैव वन रिच रिसोर्स. If you will have that resource in a richful manner, in that case the foreign companies will come and invest in that particular resource. There will be huge investment that will be done. Suppose, take the case of oil. Suppose oil is found in X country, then the from A to Z countries, they will come and invest in your country in order to exploit your oil resources. In that case, because investment will be done, your area will become attractive for the foreign direct investment. In that case, the currency of your country will see a jump. And if it will see a jump, in that case, your other commodities apart from this oil thing, they will become uncompetitive in the global market. People will have to pay you more if they want to buy the products from your country, because the value of your country will see, the value of the currency of your country will see a stupendous jump. Your products, your other products of the country will become very expensive for the other countries to buy. So only one sector will perform well as far as your economy is concerned. Other factors, other products of your economy will not be able to compete with the products from the other countries. If you want to give a boost to the exports of your country, it is important that your currency should depreciate. If your currency value will be increasing, in that case, your products will become less competitive. This is something that China had resort to in the past. China ne kya kiya, apni currency ki jo value hai, wo kam kar di. They have reduced the value of the currency. And it was only by reducing the value of the currency, China was able to remain competitive with the other markets. Now coming back to this chapter about the natural resource way. Now the states which are rich in resources, they are not able to perform well because there is utmost exploitation of their natural resources. And this is also happening in Indian case of the tribal regions, where there is excess of availability of coal, where there is excess of availability of wood, forest resources. In that case, the states, they have lagged behind in development. So basically, this chapter has negated both these factors. Basically, if a state wants to develop, first of all, it should strengthen its inner. There are certain internalities of the state that needs to be developed. There are certain ingenuous qualities that a state should. What are these ingenuous qualities? Intrinsic qualities of a state. There should be good capital availability. The workforce, the skilled workforce should be available. The capital availability should be there. There should be good transportation facilities. The state should have a simplified tax structure. There should be good connectivity with the other states. There should be good governance system. There should be proper law and order situation. These are the basic factors that helps a state to develop. Thus, solely depending on aid will not serve the purpose. And if the masses of your state are not literate, if they are not educated, if they are not aware, if they are not resourceful, then your natural resources will not help you. They will actually be exploited. And this is something that has already happened in India in the case of Andhra Pradesh, in the case of Madhya Pradesh, in the case of Odisha, in the case of Bihar, in the case of Jharkhand. So this was all for this class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, in order to build the information of the classes, visit BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.